Hey, what's up guys? It's my mind from more on goodfitness.com. And in today's video, I'm going to show you three different exercises to target the glutes. The glutes are very, very important muscles. They are the biggest muscles in the body, and they do a whole load of different movements and everything, as well as, I think, as stabilizers. If this muscle is weak, then what tends to happen is our muscles will start taking over. And believe it or not, from my experience, you don't want to go there. Because when the glutes are weak, so they're not actually shortening and lengthening properly, other muscles will start taking over and start to do their job. So it's a bit like somebody trying to dig a hole in the road with a shovel instead of one of these machines. So we're going to go through different exercises. The three muscles that are on the glutes are the glutes medius, the gluteus minimus, and the gluteus maximus. So we're going to start off with a very, very basic exercise, which is called the clams. These exercises you can do absolutely anywhere. You can do them at home, or you can do them in the gym, or you can do them in your garden, basically. So, first of all, lie down on the side, and legs on one side, and grabbing each shoulder, and then what you want to think about is lifting your glutes up. Try not to move, not to move too much. Keep your body down by holding your base of your core. Don't forget your breathing. Start to burn after a few reps, depending on your mind to muscle connection. And try the other side again. Again, just focus on lifting the glutes rather than your actual quads. If you can't feel it working, just put your hands on the actual muscle, which is start. Feel it lifting. So that exercise is called the clams. Second exercise, we're going to do a variation of the glute bridges, and you can do them either with two legs or one leg. I'm going to show you the difference. So first of all, sit down on the floor and then back on the mat. Legs bent and then head back. The first thing you want to do is contract your glutes to lift you up. Push up with your glutes, squeeze as hard as you can. Lift up as high as you possibly can. Squeeze for 2 seconds, come down. Again, squeeze glutes to contract. Go up. Try and keep your core in at the same time. Track your core belly button to the spine. That will prevent arching the lower back and your lower back muscles taking over. So that's the first variation. The second variation, we're going to do single leg. I'll show you how that's done. Again, same position, lying back. You have one leg up and squeeze. You can squeeze the glutes. Just get a push up, but you push it up. Again, core brace, squeeze the glutes, just push it up. Try the other leg. Again, squeezing the glutes as hard as you can. What you might find is you might feel a little bit of a burn in the back of your leg. If you start to do that, all you need to do is try and push your feet forward when you're contracting your glutes, and that will help you contract your glutes more than your hamstrings. Start feeling more in your glutes. Okay, so the third exercise is called the bowler squat. This is a more functional exercise that you do on loads of sports. Used on a variety of sports. This exercise I learned from a chiropractor that I went to see. Because I had an issue with my hips and my glutes weren't firing properly, this was part of the exercises that he gave me to try and engage my glutes. So it's called the bowler squat. I think it's by a guy called Dr. Stuart McGill. If you just Google Stuart McGill bowler squats, you know what I mean. Okay, so first of all, core braced, slight bend in the knee, and keep your abs in all the time. Take a deep breath in, and then push back the glutes. Head neutral, try not to fall over as I am, and then hands go across your knees. Squeeze the glutes on the way up. Back up for a squeeze again. Squeeze the glutes on the way up. And isometric squeeze at the top. Push your hips back. Try not to fall over. I'm going to do the right leg now. The more upright you are, the more you're going to start to feel it in the back of your leg and hamstring, which is not really the purpose of the exercise. So you can see I'm slightly weaker on my left side than I am on the right. So I've still got a little bit of work to do to try and get these muscles back up to strength. Alright guys, hope you liked today's video. Subscribe for more updates.